partner, and I am a senior at Mayberry. My mom has a very specific set of stories. She tells them to me when that 180 song by The Cars comes on the radio, or when we're reading Roger Ebert movie reviews, or on the rare occasion silence doesn't feel like coming home. She tells them to me so much, I often have to tell her she's repeating herself. When she tells her one about her really fat and loose habitat and post-traumatic, close for sure. He spent all of his time sunbathing in the flower box outside the living room window until he just disappeared one day, the same morning, I know. Or the one about the time her and her brothers stole unblessed communion wafers from the chapel after school and proceeded to play church in their bedroom all afternoon. I say, Mom, oh my gosh. Or when her dad regularly enjoyed fried spam sandwiches, or asked a tour guide at Graceland, who sees all these meals? Or accidentally ordered chicken nuggets instead of chicken nuggets. Or asked the nurse, can I go towards the light yet? Or the one about the time when the man she married numbed himself to her and their daughter, drowning his head in empty bottles and forgotten nights, using his heart in late-night phone calls and interrupted dinners, and where another woman found it, and say, nothing. She wrote me a letter. In it was a numbered list of some of her stories. She wrote, you know how I like to tell my stories. She told the one about the little girl who sewed a whole outfit from her stuffed penguin, by the lengthy team that he made a whole obstacle course all by herself for her camp group, about a young woman who called her hero. I still couldn't tell you why my mom tells me her story, but I will tell you, I will tell you, I've stopped telling her that she's repeating herself.